Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be going over 8 skills that are good to have if you want to become an accountant. If you want to see more of these videos, make sure you give it a thumbs up and don't forget to hit subscribe. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first skill that's really good to have is teamwork skills. You probably have done a lot of group projects and a lot of group presentations when you were a student. And as you go into the real world, a lot of that skill is transferable. One of the examples I have is for each engagement, they're usually a team. So in the team, you can have an associate doing the prep work, the senior or the manager reviewing it, and then you can have the director or the partner review and sign the deliverable. Yes, you have your individual work, but if you look at the bigger picture, you are working as a team in order to accomplish a goal. So that is definitely something you want to keep in mind. The second skill that's really good to have is the willingness to learn. There is, of course, knowledge that you're carrying from school into the real world, but at the same time, there's always an unlimited amount of things that you can learn, whether on the job or by yourself as you continue to move up the ladder. So being able to have that willingness to learn new concepts, new technical skills is really important in order to advance further into your career. Third skill that's important is the attention to detail. There are a lot of times when we have to look into detail in terms of numbers, or if you're reading detail into reading the document. So that's all things that are super helpful. When you have attention to detail skills, you're less likely to make a mistake. And if you're the reviewer, you can catch those mistakes that are made at the intern or associate level. So having the attention to details is something that you do practice when you're a student, but when you're a student, you are looking at numbers that really have no weight to it because it is just, for instance, for a test or for an assignment. But when you go into the real world, you are looking at real data from a company, from a business, and you want to make sure that you do keep that in mind. We're no longer looking at hypothetical situations in examples, but now you're looking at clients' real data. The fourth skill that's really important is communication. This is something that you learn in school, but it carries on into the real world, if not even more so. When you are working, again, in a team or when you're talking to clients, both written and verbal communication is super important because you want to be able to express things not only accurately, but also in a timely manner. Having the ability to communicate to your team members, whether that be someone that's a manager or a partner, but also to your client or to your coworkers, those skills are also things that you may need when you are working in the accounting field. And if you're working in public accounting, especially, because there are always people that you need to communicate to and also receive communication from. The fifth skill is to ask questions, and this is because, especially when you're starting off, you don't really have a lot of that technical skills as your first year or as an intern. You definitely want to ask questions. I do recommend compiling your questions and then asking your senior or your manager those questions in batches rather than disrupt as they're working throughout the day. So that's something to also keep in mind. Asking questions helps a lot and really show them where you are in terms of expertise in this specific area or topic. The sixth skill that is great to have is being able to stay organized. You are working with multiple clients and have multiple projects going on at the same exact time. I think in 1 year alone, I worked on at least 50 clients. So being able to pick a project up and see when the deadline is, being able to simultaneously work on different projects at the same time. If you're at a mid-tier firm, that's more common. When you're at a larger firm, you may just be looking at one big client, but at the same time, you may have different responsibilities. It just makes life a lot easier, just staying super organized and on top of everything. The seventh skill that's really awesome to have is being able to adapt to different changes. So being able to adapt to different technology changes, different software changes, different changes in the office, the culture, or the policies that they may have, because in 1 year alone, you will see various changes and you definitely want to be able to adapt to them as soon as possible, whether or not those changes are permanent or not, because you'll never know. To give you an example, when I first started off, I learned a very specific software and how to map trial balance accounts, and it switched 2 or 3 times till it got to the very last one. But you still had to learn all of the softwares, even though they never really finalized on that specific software. So being able to accept the change, to adapt, and later being able to apply what you learned to different types of situations is something that you also want to keep in mind, especially with technology when it comes to automation, AI, and machine learning. All of those things are going to be new changes to the accounting field that we will have to quickly get on board of in order to be ahead in terms of accounting. And the last skill is being able to give feedback that is constructive and receive those feedback from a client or from your team members, from partners, and etc. And really see how you can change the way you work in order to be an effective team member, make better quality type of work to clients, get things quicker to clients as you continue on into your career in a firm. So those are all skills that are super important. It's a good practice and good to have in order to make you a better professional. So that concludes this video. That was 8 skills that are great to have in order to be an accountant. If you want to see more of these videos, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.